Let's take a look at how we can download the evaluation versions of Windows 10 and Windows Server. So from a Google page, we can type in Windows Eval, and we'll just click on Windows Evaluation. And it takes us to the Microsoft Evaluation Center as the first option, and that's the one we want. We'll click on that, and it takes us to the new page. And what we want to do now is go to this search icon at the top of the screen. We'll click on that. And let's first search for Windows 10 Enterprise. And we'll hit Enter. And we'll see a lot of different options for this, but we're only going to choose the top one. We see that 90 days is how long the evaluation is for. So if you're taking a class, you can use this evaluation version as many times as you need for as many virtual machines as you need, if you'd like to. And most classes don't last a full 90 days. They're a little bit short of that, so you should have no issue with your evaluation version expiring. We'll click on 90 days, and now we're going to choose the ISO option. We have the LTSC. We don't use that. We use the ISO Enterprise. Now we have options for filling in our name and company name, et cetera, et cetera. You don't have to put in actual information here. As you can see, I put in all just fake information. Nothing, there is no requirement for you to put in actual information because you're not going to be getting a key or anything else like that. Now we'll click on Continue. And now we're given the option for 32-bit or 64-bit. Well, let's choose 64, and we're going to choose English, and then we'll click Download. Now we've got the Windows 10 download going. All right, so now let's go back and we'll do Windows Server this time. So this time we'll type in Windows Server and we'll type in 2016, but you can type in any version that you want that is included in here. And you'd see 2016 and 2019. You might also see 2012 as well. Now under Windows Server 2016, we see the evaluation is much longer. It's 180 days, which is great. And you can also use this over and over if you'd like. So we'll click on the 180-day version. And we see Windows Server 2016. We want to do Azure, ISO, or Virtual Lab. Let's choose the ISO option. And we can do virtual machines with that information. And once again, we're going to put in some fake information here. And once that's in, we'll click Continue once again. And we're going to see the option for the language. So we'll choose the language we want, download. And now it's downloading. Now you see I did not get the option for 32 or 64-bit, and that's simply because there's only 64-bit as an option for this version. So that is how you download the ISO files for Windows Server and Windows 10, and for the next step, what you do is go into your virtual machine product, whether that's Hyper-V, VMware, VirtualBox, and then when it prompts you for the ISO file, wherever it is that it was downloaded, which by default is going to be in your download folder, you can just point it to that, and you can use it for as many virtual machines as you would like.